हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई विल स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर्स नेबरिंग Some neighboring countries of India. Okay, so let us start with the introduction portion. What is this neighboring countries? Who is our neighbor? Generally, the country that lie close to India or share its boundary with India we called that country as the neighboring country of India. Okay, so what is the neighbor, what is the definition of the neighboring country? The country that lie close to India or shares boundary with India, we are calling that country as the neighboring country of India. India has got 8 neighboring countries, amongst them Nepal, Bhutan, then number 3 is China, number 4 is Bangladesh, number 5 is Sri Lanka, number 6 is Maldives, number 7 is Pakistan, Pakistan and Afghanistan. Number 7 is Sri Lanka. And number 8 is the Maldives. Okay. So these are the 8 neighboring countries of the India. So based on the location, Nepal, Bhutan and China are located in the northern section of the country. Okay, Bangladesh and Myanmar share its boundary with India in the eastern portion. Okay, Pakistan and Afghanistan share its boundary with India in the western portion. Sri Lanka and Maldives share its boundary with India in the southern section. So these are actually the 8 neighboring countries, or these countries are the countries which are actually sharing its boundary with the India, and that is why we are calling these 8 neighboring countries as the neighboring countries of India. Nepal, Bhutan and China sharing its these are the 3 countries where India shared its boundary in the northern portion of India. Bangladesh and Myanmar are the countries which where the India is sharing its border in the eastern direction. Pakistan and Afghanistan is located in the next is the Pakistan of the Afghanistan sharing its boundary in the western section. Then is the Sri Lanka and Maldives, which is sharing its boundary in the southern portion of the India. Also in the northern part of the India, Nepal is also located in the northern part of the India. Then we have the Myanmar. Myanmar is located to the east of India. When in the Bangladesh, Bangladesh is also located to the east of the India. Next is the Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is located to the south of the India. Then we have the Maldives over here, which is also located to the south of the India. And the last one is the Pakistan, which is located in the western portion of India. Okay,
With all this country, India has a political, cultural and ethnic relationship since the time immemorial. All these countries, including India, lie in the southern portion of the Asia, and India occupies the central location among all other these eight neighboring countries. Okay, a good relationship is need to be kept with the different country or neighboring countries because one is for the socio-cultural factors, because India shares its identical geographical location with all other neighbors. As a result of that, it should maintain a good relationship between India and adjacent all other neighboring countries. Okay, next is for the political factor. India needs to maintain a good relationship with all her neighbors to protect itself from the invasion of the different neighboring countries, and to also to minimize our expenditure for the defense of the country. And the last one is the economic factor. India, being a progressing industrial country, has several industry. For that, it has a great demand for the diversified raw materials. So some of these raw materials are needed to be imported from other neighboring countries too. Okay, and that's the reason it should maintain a good relationship based on the economic factor also. India also maintain a cooperation with the neighboring countries for various joint projects, like the Indo-Bhutan project for the river Chukha, hydropower project system. Then Indo-Nepal river projects also is there, based on the different rivers that the rises or that has a source in the Nepal and it flows into the India. You can see many rivers that is being marked in the black, starting having their sources over here, and it is flowing in India. Okay, so to for the purpose of maintaining the peace and the harmony, an organization is being formed named as the SAARC, which is actually the full form of the SAARC is South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, which is established in the year 1985. This organization emphasizes in the importance of the mutual cooperation and understanding among the different nations in Indian subcontinent. The member of the SAARCs are India, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Maldives, Sri Lanka and Pakistan. The headquarters of the SAARC is located in Kathmandu.